First of all, let me say thank you, Brooklyn. Thank you to all the fans. Thank you, New York, for giving Ryan all the love. All the love he deserves.
Yes, sir.
Everybody said, oh, this fight doesn't belong on the East Coast. And this, look at the arena. Pay-per-views are going to be through the roof. And Ryan Garcia as the champ. Come on, baby.
Yeah. Let's go.
Thank you guys for coming, but first and foremost, I want to thank Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. All glory to Him. You know, this is why people need to stop believing everything on the internet and stop, you know, living in a false reality. At the end of the day, there's a lot of real shit going on. You know, the last thing you should worry about is a kid acting crazy on the internet. Real shit is going on in the world. Open your eyes. You know, kids being hurt, nobody caring. Everybody looking at it like, oh, he's just crazy. It's a conspiracy. It's this, it's that. At the end of the day, that shit was real. And I out there put that my reputation on the line, had everybody thinking I was crazy. At the end of the day, who's the crazy one now? You know, I didn't really want to say this, but it's the truth. You know, everybody needs to acknowledge, like, yo, I'm tripping. Y'all was tripping, not me. You guys were tripping. I was the one that was actually with sanity, because I'm like, yo, they're hurting their kids. Let's help them. That's called being a real man, because I don't give a fuck what people say about me.
That's right.
I walked through the fire and still held it down and still beat fucking Devin Haney and still drank every day and still beat him. And I did everything. What the fuck? Hey, what happened?
False reality, right?
Drank every single night, went out on the first Monday and a Tuesday and Monday. What happened? I won him. Not necessarily am I proud of that, but I'm just saying. It was a statement to show you. You guys can't really fuck with me.
That's right.
I do whatever I want.
That's cool. He did settle down on Sunday though.
Just imagine.
I don't know.
If none of that happened, and he stayed in camp for 8 weeks.
Oh, I did do that. But I just.
Just imagine. See, use your imagination, cause y'all.
I'll fall for
perfect. All right, we're
gonna
start taking some questions.
Fine. First of all, congratulations on this amazing victory. Tell us what went through your mind in the first lockdown, because everybody from the beginning of the first bell to the 12th, I kid you not, everybody was just on their feet. But what was running through your mind?
Is this going to be the moment I stop him? That's just all I was thinking. I shouldn't have put too much pressure on myself to stop him. Because every time I heard him, I just went crazy and I just couldn't finish him. But I think, what's his name, Harvey Duff? I think he was tripping. He should have stopped that fight.
Yeah, he should have stopped the first
time. It was bad. He was really hurt. And I felt bad. I even looked at Bill. 11th round, 12th round. I was like, bro, you probably should stop this. But he didn't. And that's it.
Radio around here, check and tell. I am curious what you did think overall of the referee's performance, particularly in the 7th round.
Horrible. It was a horrible round.
Yeah, I mean, the guy was holding me for dear life. And I found an opportunity to keep swinging while my hands were free. And I cracked him, and then he took point away when I cracked him. But he held me, and then, like, I should have knocked him out in that 7th round. They stole that from me.
Yeah, the referee was horrible. I think everybody in the arena saw it was horrible. It should have been stopped the first time, and Devin was holding and holding and holding, and Ryan got a point deducted for him. That was ridiculous.
That was crazy. I never seen some shit like that. He was holding me, and I just whacked him, and then he was hurt, and I was like, yes, done. And then, oh, point taken out.
Darrell Josh Johnson, Amsterdam News. In the front, Ryan, and I'd love to hear what Bernard and Oscar have to say too. Brilliant game plan, Ryan. Did you think Haney felt your power in the first round? How did you proceed then on?
He got wobbled bad. I mean, I'm surprised he has such good heart and like recovery. Bro, I cracked him in that first round. I thought it was over. I'm like, I want easy work. And then he came out firing in the second. He even hurt me with the hook. And I was like, damn, maybe you do got a little power.
Mike Hovinger,
ESPN.
Yeah, I see.
Congratulations, Ryan.
Thank you.
Look, Oscar, you said in the lead up to this fight that some fighters thrive in the chaos. Yeah. The chaotic buildup really help you focus on.
So you don't know half of the shit I've been through my life. Like, that shit was nothing. Like, I've been through some crazy ass moments. This whole fight week was crazy. Like, crazy. You have no clue. Y'all have no clue. Fucking no clue. Shit's hilarious. It'll come out one day.
Do you have a call?
Yeah. And, okay. Oscar, what do you
swear? I swear I had brown hair on Monday. Now I got gray hair.
No, but look, Ryan, I mean, look, Devin Haney was on everyone's pound list. He's a great boxer, and you dropped him three times. He'd never been down before.
What a huge win. Mike, it's about five or six times. You call it knocked down.
Right.
Yeah, about five or six times.
Well, look, how does this feel? You know, you were counted out, and this is a monster victory.
I mean, like I said, me and my coach, he's instilled in my mind, literally brainwashed me, what's next? So at the end of the day, what's next? I don't care. Like, at the end of the day, I already knew I could beat him. I was supremely confident. Am I happy? Of course. But at the end of the day, like, I'm all about trying to fulfill the will of God and keep it moving. So, what's next? Who's next?
Amen.
Let's
go. Amen.
God did.
Amen.
God did.
Hey, Ryan, what's going on, man? Right in the front, right? Yeah. This is Najee from Cigar Talk. Congratulations. Big win tonight. This win, you know, in spectacular fashion with all the knockdowns, people have already started clamoring about a Tank part two. How do you feel? Just, you know, obviously Tank has to take care of his business with Frank Martin in June, but how do you feel? What are your thoughts on trying to make that happen?
That's disrespectful. Real disrespectful.
Yeah. Yeah. Disrespectful?
You don't talk about whatever after that, but that's disrespectful.
He trains Frank Martin.
We're not going to get into that. I like him. I'm going to take everything at the same time.
I know I interviewed Derek. Derek knows. I'm just saying is that's a fight that people are clamoring for.
At the end of the day, Tank,
no disrespect. Respect.
I don't think Tank's gonna beat Frank Martin, but if he did, he wouldn't fight me because I'm moving up. I'm not doing 140. I'm going 147. I can't make fucking 140. I never even technically fought at 140. I fought every time at 143. True. My body can't literally go lower than 143. It's impossible. I tried every technique. Can't do it.
The only way he's gonna fight Tank Davis, it's a catch weight, okay? At 45, 44, just the way they did it to him.
Yep.
Yeah. Now he's the man. Now he's the face of boxing.
Let's go, Ryan.
Come on now. Derek James, the father.
In my opinion, I believe a rematch with Devin will be a step back. In your opinion, who would you like to fight next? And could it be in New York? I felt like the New York crowd was really gravitating.
I mean, I had a vision to fight Fondura at 154. I don't know why. I just feel like I could knock him out. I know that's really, really random, but I just feel like I could get a title at 154. Real quick, I fought guys that big before, and I've knocked them out in sparring. Cold. Slept them. So, I want to do it. Shout out Fondura, though. No disrespect. Or I don't know.
Look, bottom line is this.
Go rest.
Let's go back to the drawing board. We're going to pick the best fight that Ryan thinks is the best fight, and we're going to make big fights. We're going to make big pay-per-views. That's what it's all about. Give the fans what they want.
Look, I'll tell you the truth. Ryan is going to rest. Had a great win. Let him enjoy it.
Enjoy this.
And guess what? Ryan's calling all the shots now.
Yep.
Ryan's calling all the shots now. That's the fact.
He wants to
fight at 47. He wants to fight at catchweight. But guess what? If anybody wants to make money, they have to fight Ryan. And guess what? He's going to call all the shots. That's it.
He's right.
And guess what? He's going to give you an exciting fight every single time.
Right.
Oh, one more. This is Kyle Dipp from the boxing section. One for Ryan and one for Derrick James. How important was to have Derrick James in your corner?
Oh yeah, that's a major key. You know, we just have a great chemistry. Derrick is like a father figure. Besides obviously my dad, but he's like a father figure, and he always pulls me aside and. He done seen me cry before, and he was like, man, you good. He's like, don't worry about it. He's like, you don't get through this, man. You're going to get through this.
What did he say?
He said, you're going to get through this. You're going to get through it.
No doubt. I had a good conversation with him yesterday. I'm just letting him know that I understand what he's going through. I understand the pain. I understand everything. And, you know, at the same time, I can you know, I can comfort him, but at the same time, I'm gonna get on his ass too.
Too fast.
He get on there, I get on, I talk to him, I talk bad to him.
Fast.
All right, Brian. All right,
I just want to say one more thing, okay? I'm so glad. People that I'm gonna mention, Pauly Malignaggi,
Timothy Bradley,
Chris Algieri, Steve Kim, maybe Mario Lopez, maybe, but they're all a piece of shit. Okay?
Oh shit!
And I'm so glad that's right. The fucking law and Brian proved them wrong.
Yeah, Timothy Bradley, suck my dick.